Yo guys, what's going on? It's 1-9 here, and I know, before anyone says anything, this is not the same shirt from the last video, and these are the same jeans, but this isn't the same shirt. I take a shower, guys, come on. So, by the title of the video, guys are already seeing what's happening. Ignore all this is part of the video, this is going to be for the next video about how I clean my engine bay and all that stuff, so yeah, I hope you guys find that interesting. But yeah, so apparently, I ran away from the cops without me knowing, or without any knowledge of anything going on, which by what I mean by that is I didn't, of course. So to start off in the beginning of the story, I was accused of running from the sheriff's department, which is here in this little small town where I live. A lot of you guys know where I live. I'm not going to say where I do live because I don't want to point that out. But yeah, so you guys, if you guys follow me on Instagram, you guys saw that I posted my story. A while back, probably like at least a month or two, I think 2 months, I posted a story of me getting a fixing ticket for my front plate, which I have on right now with my stone show bracket. The reason why I didn't have my front plate was because I didn't hit a pothole. There was a driveway which was really steep, and as soon as I hit it, it literally cracked my stone show. So I had to hammer it down just to make it work again for this fixing ticket. And when I got the fixing ticket, I was outside washing my car. And to talk about the sheriff that gave me this fix-it ticket, he was completely rude. He told me before, or at the end of one of the clips that I have, I'm not sure if I still have them because I uploaded them just on my Instagram. He told me at the end of the clip, and I quote in his words, "You better fix that fucking exhaust because that's a big fucking fix-it ticket." He told me like that and just walks away. So I got my fixing ticket. I wasn't really pissed off about it. I know I kind of ticked them off because I had my GoPro running, and I know I'm kind of asking for it because cops don't like being recorded. So I got my fixing ticket, and a few weeks go by, I get it signed off, and this is where the accusation came. I wave him down, and before he wants to sign off my fixing ticket, he tells me to get my keys and to turn on the car. And I'm like, I don't need to turn on the car. You came to sign my front plate. As you can see, it's still here. And at this point, we're arguing back and forth. My dad comes out and he says he doesn't need to turn on the car. And the cop, I guess he got upset. And then he starts saying that, well, this exact car 2 days ago ran away from us in the morning. I'm like, in the morning, okay. One, I wasn't here in the morning. I left at 6 to go to a car meet in Fresno. And then he goes on to say, well, I met a couple days ago, and I'm not like by 2 days. I'm like, no, you said 2 days. I'm like, no, I met a couple days ago. So he tries to change up the story and says that I ran away from him another day, which was completely a lie because even my dad can vouch for me for this. I didn't drive my car at all around town because I've noticed that it's been getting really heated lately with cops. So I don't want to get state reffed or anything like that. So I just don't drive it here. I just drive it to Fresno or when I go out of town. And yeah, so right then and there, his accusation was already bullshit. You can't accuse me and not and then I even said this to him. I said, if I was to run from you, wouldn't I be in handcuffs right now? And that's when he got to the point to where like, okay, you can't fuck with them, or I can't fuck with them. And mind my language, guys, I was kind of really pissed about this. And it still gets me pissed off how he accused me of that. After that, he insists that I turn on the car, and I was like, no, I don't have to. And then he asked what exhaust I have. I just told him I had Flowmasters, like any other Mustang would, like any old Mustang would. And yeah, after that, he just signs the ticket, goes on his way, and then, yeah. Then, 2 weeks later, not 2 weeks, like a week, no, a few days later, I'm coming home. I got off the freeway, and literally the freeway's like right over here, so I just go down the street, turn left, and I'm here at my house. And I'm getting to the intersection about 200-300 feet away. I see him, he's at the intersection. And he has the right of way. He was there before any of the other cars, but he starts waving cars to go in front of him until I got there. And when I got there, that's when he tells me to go. I was like, oh, okay, so I go, and I get to my house, okay, and I guess he tried catching up to me. To light me up before I get into my driveway. I get up my driveway, I park in my garage, and I look in the rearview mirror. He's literally stopped right there in the street, just looking at me, and he has like his arm like this, just dogging me. I'm like, seriously? Like, you're harassing me now at this point. And that's harassment at that point. And, you know, I didn't think much of it, but now that it's been a couple, probably, a week or so, I've drove by him a few times. He says what's up and hi, and I was outside washing my car. He just waved at me. I guess he realized it wasn't me. And, you know, I don't blame him because I know there's a few Mustangs, and how Mustangs from far away looked exactly similar because of the vertical taillights. But I wouldn't risk running away in this car. And, yeah, that's basically it for the story. I said I was going to upload more. There's going to be a second video coming out later on about the engine bay. Hope you guys like and enjoy that. It's getting kind of hot in here because of the heat of the engine. So I'm probably going to let it cool down, and then I'll start getting onto that. So, yeah. Hope you guys like and enjoy. This has been One Hand. This is my story of how I ran away from the police. You know, it's kind of clickbaity, but hey, gotta get the views, right? So, yeah. Hope you guys like and enjoy. I'm One Hand. I'm out. Leave a like, comment, subscribe if you're new, and yeah, leave a comment. I like seeing comments. I don't know why. When I see comments, I feel like people actually watch the video and pay attention. So yeah, peace out, guys. It's been One Hand. One more thing, guys. Before anyone says this is complete bullshit, I can't really prove that I was accused by the cop because I didn't have any recorded footage of that. I do have footage of the other cop accusing me or about to fix the ticket about how rude he was, but I'm not sure I'm gonna put it in. They've been quite nice lately, and I don't want to, you know, make it seem that I really hate cops. But right here, I do have to fix the ticket. It's it says right here, VC 3200, no front plate. And it shows my street number and everything. Officer Hector Negrete. And yeah, and then in the back, you can see I have it signed off. I'm not sure if it's going to focus, but I have it signed off right there. I'm not sure if you guys can even see it through the blurriness of the camera if it's not focused. But yeah, it is signed off and everything by the officer. The other officer was named F. Serrano, so I'm not really sure who he is. But yeah, I don't blame them. I mean, there is a lot of people running, like I said. But it wasn't me.